ancestor. No one is claiming that humans and chimps are identical. That is not the claim. So Sabor's argument is a total and utter straw man. The question is, do humans and chimps share a common ancestor? Not are humans and chimps identical, or how different are humans and chimps in terms of their behaviours. We are not claiming humans and chimps are identical. We are not claiming that the genetic evidence tells us exactly how similar we are to chimps in terms of our behaviours. No. What we're saying the genetic evidence does is tell us that humans and chimps share a common ancestor. And I've asked him for even one paper in a high-impact journal like Nature that I quoted that says the opposite conclusion. And he cannot quote even one.
What conclusion?
One, right?
What conclusion?
That humans and chimps share a common ancestor.
No, they all have that conclusion based upon the assumption of homology.
It's based off of the data.
And the data is looked at basing...
Have you got any data that goes the other way?
For the data to go the other way, I need a rival null hypothesis. Okay. But the null hypothesis which you gave is that of randomness. Anything is going to be better than randomness.
So now, give me another one. Give me some data.
I didn't give you a paper. I gave you an evolutionary biologist who's describing the way the field works.
Which you misquoted.
Okay. If I misquoted him, then tell me this. What book did I misquote him from?
Elliot Sober was Evolution.
No, the book is What It Means to Be 98% Chimpanzee.
Okay.
Right?
Fine.
You even got the book wrong.
That was a different quote.
You weren't listening.
No.
We moved on since that point.
You've done so many misquotes, before. It's hard to know which one you were
Wait, for you to say I've misquoted, you need to give evidence. Here's the point. What atheists do is this. You misquoted. But what they do themselves is look at this amazing piece of evidence. Look at this amazing piece of evidence. And when I ask him, what's the null hypothesis? It's randomness. Hang on a second. If you're going to give us evidence, which is supposed to be conclusive, you are misquoting when you don't give the entire story, when you don't explain what the null hypothesis is, and whether that null hypothesis is actually justified. Now, what he said, what Jonathan Marks said, is that I'm misquoting him, but he himself has never read that book.
I have read that book.
You've read this book?
Yep.
Okay, so tell me, in this book, what does Jonathan Marks say genetics has done to the conversation about homology?
Okay, it's a long time since I read that book, but my recollection was that what he was saying was that the difference between humans and chimps is more than simply the 1 or 2% quoted, 98% similar or 99% similar or 96%. That what created the difference between humans and chimps was regulatory changes in the growth factors in humans' human neocortex. Right?
Okay, you haven't read the book, have you?
I have.
Okay, so read this part.
Okay, fine. Okay. Other species appear to agree. Okay, we've read this.
Wait, wait. Read it.
Okay. Other species appear to agree, but none weep as humans do. And certainly not imaginary events like those in Les Miserables and Love Story. What does genetics have to say about all this? Nothing.
Right? Nothing.
But that's not the question. That is not the question, Sabor. You're quoting this completely out of
context. Finish the quote.
Sameness, otherness is a philosophical paradox which is resolved by argument, not by data. Genetic data tells precisely what we already knew. The human apes are very similar to different from great apes. But that's completely irrelevant.
And that's what I've been saying for the last two hours.
I've got to respond to this. I've got to respond to this.
Sure.
Right? Because what he's saying is, how similar are humans and chimps? Do they have emotions? Do they weep at Les Miserables? That is not the question that we're asking. Humans and chimps could be very, very different at an emotional level, right? We in evolution, what we say is that humans have a brain that's, say, 1,400 cc's. Chimps is only about, 300, 400 cc's. So what there was a very large increase in the neocortex of the human, right?
Did anyone hear that in the quote? That
quote captures the whole book, does it, Sabor?
No, it doesn't, and you clearly haven't read it, so you don't know what the other parts are. So here's the thing.
Does he say
wait, one second.
That humans and chimps differed because of acceleration in the growth factors of the neocortex genes, yes or no?
I can't think of that.
He
maybe
does
he
say
said
that.
Maybe he
does
said it
say that.
Okay, but he even if he does that. Say that, that's irrelevant to this point. The point I'm making here is I let Phil speak about genetics, and here you have an evolutionary biologist saying the philosophical paradox is not resolved by genetic data, and sameness, otherness is a philosophical paradox that is not resolved, that's resolved by argument, not by data. Genetic data tells us precisely what we already knew, that humans are both similar and very different to great apes.
But not about the question of someone answers.
So, genetics doesn't add anything different to what Erasmus Darwin, which I began off with, which is Darwin's grandfather, believed, which is homology. It does nothing different. Now move on to fossils if you want.
All right, fine. Okay, so I just want to respond, because whether humans and chimps, how similar they are in terms of their emotions and so on, I agree that genetics doesn't tell us that. That's a difficult question.
Sure.
But it does tell us about humans and chimp common ancestry.
Sure.
Okay, so I'm running out of time, so I'm going to...
I'm not running out of time.
I know, but I am.
Didn't you ask for this debate?
Yes.
And you took we took a few weeks for it to get arranged. You wanted to do it in a university, right? We're here in the park.
Right.
So now you're claiming I'm misquoting. So what you need to do is, if you're going to make those claims, you need to substantiate them, or else you're going to look like a fool walking away right now.
I did substantiate them.
You didn't?
Yes, okay. Do you want me to say the same thing again?
No, you didn't substantiate anything. You only spoke about genetics, and I just showed you genetics not resolved. It doesn't resolve the ancient problem of homoplasia and homology.
Okay.
Go to fossils.
Okay, fine.
We need to go through all of them.
Okay, fine. Let's go on. Okay. So if evolution is true, okay, if we find hominid fossils, we should find fossils that have transitional forms, okay? And we do. So for example, as I said, chimpanzee brain is about 300 or 400 cc's. And if we look at the human brain, it's about 1400 cc's, okay? So if we look at hominid fossils, what we should find is that the brain size is gradually increasing over time. So let me show you. So basically, if evolution is true, then we should have an upward sloping graph for brain size versus time, okay? And that is precisely what we find. Let me give you the graph of the data. Just pull it up, give me a second. Here it is. Okay, here's a detailed version of the data. What you see is that the earliest hominid fossils have quite small brains, and very gradually it's going up. So if evolution is true, we should see this upward sloping graph going to the right, increasing brain size over time. That's exactly what we see. And there's another way to look at it called encephalization quotient, which is the brain size as proportion to the body size. Okay? And here is a graph. You can see Australopithecus afarensis, Homo habilis, Homo erectus, Homo sapiens, all gradually going upwards over time. Now, it's not just brain size. We have other things in our anatomy. So if you look at Australopithecus, okay, here's Australopithecus. The blue features are the features that Australopithecus has in common with humans. So to give you an example, barrel-shaped rib cage, flexible lumbar region, short and broad pelvis, blah, 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 blah. Okay? The orange ones are what Australopithecus has in common with chimps. So it's got these features in common with chimps, and has features in common with humans. So just to give you an example, and it's medium, right? So to give you another example, not just brain size. So Australopithecus is an animal that had a human upright stance, but it had a chimpanzee-sized brain. Okay? There are other intermediate features in Australopithecus as well. So for example, chimpanzees walk like this. They do knuckle movement. So they have long arms for that. The arm ratio is 100% of the legs. Okay? Now, in humans, it's about 70%, because we don't do this knuckle. So our arms are not on top. Okay? Now, what's on Australopithecus? Bang in the middle! 85% arm ratio to leg ratio. Okay? Bang in the middle. And there are many, many features. You can look at the teeth as well. They have reduced canines. Intermediate between humans and chimps. So the fossil evidence, and also, we also have the location, okay? They're in sub-Saharan Africa, And the genetic evidence also points to the common ancestor must have been a
okay.
So the fossil evidence is very, very evolution is true. So the reasonable thing to do is to conclude, based on the evidence, that evolution, human to common ancestry, is true.
Okay. So what you've mentioned there is still based on the assumption of homology. And even with that assumption, we still have recalcitrant facts. So I'll give you an example. You're speaking about the famous Lucy fossil and how it's supposed to be bipedal. It's supposed to have some evidence that it was actually walking on two. Now, we actually have, how old is Lucy? Something like four million years old
no,
or whatever.
It's about 3 million years old.
Fine, 3 million years old.
Yeah.
So we have apes which were fully bipedal in southern Italy about 10 million years ago, right? Those are not used as our sort of most recent common ancestor compared to something like Lucy. Now, this is assuming...
So a bipedal ape in bipedal southern Italy?
In southern Italy, yeah.
Give me a reference.
And wait, hang on a second. He realizes it's a recalcitrant fact. So let me give you the evidence. If this bipedal ape does exist in southern Italy, which is 10 million years old, we have a recalcitrant fact, and I'm going to make 2 points before I give him the evidence for that. One, this still doesn't disprove human chimp ancestry because of methodological naturalism, because of homology, and two, this recalcitrant fact is going to be explained using an ad hoc rationalization. Those 2 points.
Okay. You haven't addressed anything about transitional forms, have you? Why is it that we have this upward sloping graph in all the hominid fossils? Why, Sabor? Can you give me a reason?
Sahara used to be like green lagoon, Sahara Desert.
Sorry?
Sahara Desert used to be green lagoon.
No, it's not that we used to be a gorilla. That's a misunderstanding of evolution.
No.
Evolution doesn't say we used to be gorillas. What it says is that we share a common ancestor. Okay? That's not the same as saying we used to be gorillas. Okay?
Carry on, I'm just looking for the reference.
Yeah, go ahead. Okay, this is, okay, I mean, what more to say? This is the graph of hominid ancestors. Okay? You can see a clear pattern here, a very clear pattern, upward sloping, right? That's exactly what we'd expect.
But that's still based on the assumption of homology. I don't see how you're giving anything different.
You keep saying this phrase like it's some sort of magic wand. Based on the assumption of homology. You can assume whatever you like. The data is the data.
Yeah.
Right? And the data confirms the hypothesis.
Yes. Okay,
right? And everyone in paleontology agrees with that.
Wait, hang on.
Okay? Then you quote me a paper.
Okay, wait.
I've challenged you to quote me a paper in a high-impact journal like Nature or Science or whatever that says, no, we have clear evidence against human-chimp common ancestry. And you haven't quoted even one paper.
That's the point I actually made.
Even one.
Wait, that's the point I actually made. There is no piece of data which can go against that.
There you go.
Because, wait, hang on. You agreed with me. There is no point, there is no piece of data which can go against that.
Say can or does.
That can. Nothing.
Well, that's not true. That's not true.
Wait, no, it is. It is.
That's completely
it's true.
False.
It's actually true.
All right.
I'll tell you
so,
why it's true.
So how would it be?
One second. Let me answer, yeah? The book is Science and Human Origins. This is written by, these are Christian.
This is a book?
Yes.
Well, no, we want a scientific paper, Sabor, not
wait,
a book.
Wait, hang on.
Anyone can publish anything
wait,
in a
wait,
book.
Phil,
that's
Phil,
not peer
Phil,
review.
Phil, Phil,
I want something in a
Phil.
Proper journal.
Phil, one second. Phil, one second. One second.
Sorry, that's irrelevant.
I'm not dealing with this point. I'm dealing with the earlier point of the Italian ape.
Yeah, I want a
right.
reference in a proper peer review journal.
What, the existence of this ape?
And that it was in Italy, and that it's 10 million years old, and that it's bipedal.
Wait, hang on a second.
And I want it in a proper peer-reviewed journal, not in a book.
Wait, hang on. Then I have to actually go to the page. All right,
go
carry
to
on.
You need. Right, he can't find it. No surprise.
Well, wait, hang on a second. If I did find it, or if I didn't actually find it, it wouldn't make a difference to my overall argument, which I'm actually making, and which you've admitted, that if there is this Italian ape, which is 10 million years old, which is fully bipedal, this is a recalcitrant fact. But this does not, and this reconfirms something I said earlier, this does not falsify human chimp ancestry, because nothing can.
Well, okay, he says nothing can falsify human chimp ancestry.
Because of methodological naturalism and homology.
Okay, all right, let me just address that point, right? First off, it's, as we established, it's nothing to do with methodological naturalism, because we could have a perfectly naturalistic explanation for human origins that's nothing to do with evolution. You could be someone that believes in spontaneous creation, and people were. Aristotle believes in spontaneous creation. Many other ancient Greeks, I think it was Anaxagoras, believed in it. Okay, so it's nothing from naturalism that says that humans and chimps have to share a common ancestor, and human and chimps' common ancestry is falsifiable. Of course, any one piece of evidence, you know, has to be taken in the context of all the evidence, right? So it's true that, you know, you have to look at all the evidence, okay? Multiple lines of evidence. If you just found one thing, of course, you have to look at the broad picture, okay?
Now, I'm doing call a friend.
Okay, fine. Yeah, I mean, we've been going for 2 hours.
No, wait. I need to give you this reference first.
Okay,
I believe.
Right, okay, now, the point is, if it were the case that we found that, going back to my original example.
Samro, how are you doing? Human, bro, I need a quick favour. Hello?
The nano P.
I need a quick favour. You know that Italian ape that we were speaking about, which was discovered in southern Italy? What was it called?
Right? If we found that humans and chimps.
Which was fully bipedal.
Their amino acid sequence.
Can you WhatsApp me the name and just WhatsApp me where they like some reference where they discovered it?
That would falsify evolution. If that graph.
Okay, I need an ASAP. Kind of debating an atheist right now.
If that graph didn't have that pattern, that would go against human evolution, right?
Okay.
Let me give you another test, right?
Hello.
If humans and chimps share a common ancestor, right? Then what we should find is that the genetic diversity in human populations should be highest at the center of origin. This is called Vavilov's theorem. This is widely accepted in genetics. The origin center is where you have the highest genetic diversity. So we could look at different ethnicities, Europeans, Eskimos, Native Americans, Aboriginals, whoever. And if evolution is true, sub-Saharan Africans should have the highest genetic diversity. If it turned out that Eskimos had the highest genetic diversity, that would be evidence against human-chimp common ancestry. That would be evidence against human-chimp.
Hang on. That's a non sequitur.
No, it isn't.
That's a total non sequitur. You're assuming, and this is a very racist thing, by the way, that East Africa is where you have the great apes, and that's where the black people are.
No, so that's where you have the fossils.
Wait, hang on.
It's not racist.
Is racist, and I'll tell you why.
How is it racist?
I'll tell you why. Because we do actually have fossils which are also in other parts of Asia, such as China, which could also be interpreted as the beginning of human beings. Now, your argument is a non sequitur.
You're wrong.
Okay.
You made your point.
Let me make
South Saharan Africa. The oldest
fossil of recently that discovered of a human being is actually in Morocco, North Africa.
A human being?
Yes.
That's not what we're talking about.
Yes.
We're talking about the oldest hominid fossils, where Australopithecus is.
Yes.
Where Orinid is.
Yes.
Where all these, there's nothing to do with where
You're assuming those are human ancestors.
Well, no, if that's where human ancestry is, then we can confirm it with another piece of evidence. That's the point. This is what you completely misunderstand every time.
So
you say, oh, we're just assuming this.
Okay.
The whole point is the data can confirm or deny the assumptions.
Wait, hang on.
And the data overwhelmingly confirms it.
Okay, Phil, here's the thing. The fossils which are found in East Africa, those fossils, none of them, and here's the point which I'm making, have been proven to be human ancestors. Every single one of those fossils that's been discovered, those discoveries are based on the assumption of homology and the assumption which is actually made And here's the point. Here's the point. Look, I'm going to make an
argument.
Sir, I'm debating one person at a time. I'll speak to you next. Lucy is assumed to be a human chimp ancestor. Is